Okay, hi everyone. Although clinical trials have shown efficacy for chemotherapy across a broad range of tumour groups, these trials are generally limited to fit patients of a younger age than the general cancer population. The studies of these same protocols in the older, less fit patients have shown greater morbidity, and so tailoring of therapy is a common practice. In 2016, an inquiry was undertaken by the Ministry of Health in New South Wales in relation to the off-protocol prescribing of chemotherapy, when 103 patients were identified as receiving a flat dose of a drug, and this practice was not supported by any literature. The incidents highlighted the importance of cancer centres to constantly monitor prescribing practices. How this is best done is largely undocumented in the literature, and there was only one study that we found that reported tailoring rates for protocols. Given tailoring of chemotherapy doses from standard protocols is accepted, there needs to be an understanding of the reasons for these variances. In Southwest Sydney Local Health District, we convened a committee that had two primary aims. The first was to strengthen our governance processes to ensure that patients were receiving safe chemotherapy and that the staff felt empowered to raise concerns when they found unusual prescribing practices. Our second aim, which is the focus of my talk, is about the quality audit tool that we developed. And we wanted it to highlight first cycle chemotherapy dose variances of more than 5%. We also wanted the tool to be able to tell us when a dose adjustment reason was not provided by the clinician, and to also give us a list of drugs that were prescribed without the use of an electronic protocol. Clinical data that we routinely capture in Mosaic, our oncology information system, was the source for our data, and we use crystal reports for our data extracts and our visualization. We developed 5 reports in our audit tool that are run on a monthly basis, and they're distributed to our managers. The first set of reports highlight dose variances for the first cycle chemotherapy drugs that had a dose variance of more than 5%. And then we supplemented this with a summary report at a facility and a clinician level that will show us the number of orders that were prescribed, the number that were varied, and the dose adjustment reasons that were given by the clinician. The second set of reports focused on the drugs that were prescribed without an electronic protocol. And this was also supplemented with a physician with a summary report at a clinician level. We were then able to drill down and assess our data and assess the prescribing practices. We found that for our facilities, we had a range of 10 to 20% of our chemotherapy drugs, cycle one orders, had a dose variance. 80% of chemotherapy protocols had at least one drug dose varied. And 75% of these drug dose variances had a documented reason in the Mosaic field that we actually assessed. The proportion of chemotherapy drugs that were prescribed without the electronic protocol was around 2% for medical oncology and between 5 and 6% for hematology. There was much debate at the outset about what proportion of dose variation we wanted to review periodically, and some said 20%, some said 10%, but in the end we chose a conservative 5%. Accepted evidence-based chemotherapy protocols are published on the EverQ website by the Cancer Institute of New South Wales, and these are the general standard for prescribing in Australia. These protocols, among others, are those available to the clinicians for prescribing in our Mosaic system. EverQ protocols do allow some room for variation depending on patient factors, particularly performance status and laboratory results. So not all of the variation we actually see in our audit reports are off protocol or not, they are actually acceptable. Without a robust range of chemotherapy protocols in our electronic library, clinicians may select a protocol that's close enough to what they need for the patient and then modify it to fit the specific patient scenario. This was found to be the case for some of our ovarian EverQ protocols, where depending on the performance status of the patient, the carboplatin dose is calculated based on a 5 or a 6 AUC. We only had one option available to our clinicians in Mosaic, and so the doctors were using it and then regularly modifying the dose of the carboplatin, and this has actually inflated our variance proportions for ovarian protocols, even though they actually have been prescribed appropriately but difficult to identify electronically. In 2014, the Mount Sinai Medical Centre in Canada reported the rate of evidence evidence-based adherence of their chemotherapy protocols to be 86%, and this was soon after implementing electronic system in their centres. It's unclear how they defined protocol modification. It is likely that they did include dose variation, but they probably also included dose drug additions and omissions, and maybe even changes to the frequency of a chemotherapy cycle. They've quoted 80% as being an adherence rate, as being a realistic target. And despite the uncertainty of the definition, our results are consistent with these recommendations. Mosaic does provide the user with the capacity to record up to three reasons for the dose variances. In this study, we only included one of those fields because we've actually set it to be mandatory when a dose variance is documented. So we were actually expecting to see 100% of dose adjustment reasons being documented, not 75%. And then when we investigated further, we found that you can make a dose adjustment or dose variance to a drug in a different screen of Mosaic where you don't actually have the option to put a reason in. So despite the gap, the oncologist pharmacists were telling us that these the reasons for the dose variance are actually documented, and they're documented in the clinical notes. We're actually now developing trending reports, and I've shown some of those up on the slide. And these monitor prescribing practices over time. And we're actually seeing that in the last 12 months, our reports are actually showing an improvement in the amount of dose variation that we're seeing for our protocols. And we're very close to 90% of the chemotherapy protocols being prescribed with no dose variation at all. Physician feedback is given by presenting our audit reports at monthly morbidity or mortality meetings, and this has helped drive the improvement we're seeing. We've actually just completed a 5-year review of chemotherapy prescribing data, and a manuscript's in development, and we're moving forward, we'll be working with other chemotherapy centres to benchmark first cycle chemotherapy dose variation across the state. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Nasreen. Does anybody have any questions? I have a question. I noticed that you mentioned that there seemed to be a bit of a gap in the screen that you thought they were using versus the screen that they were using. I just wondered what the process of informing the clinicians about where they needed to record this information was, and whether or not, in retrospect, you would do something differently.
Yep, so it's all about education and making sure that the clinicians are following the correct processes. So we have documented procedure manuals that have been around for years that actually say where you do, you know, you click this button to do a dose adjustment reason. And when the clinicians found a workaround, they were doing it, they were actually using that workaround. And so now we're going to start in services to make sure that everybody goes back to the procedure manual and does things the correct way. The other thing that I wasn't able to talk about was that we're actually seeing, we're reducing the amount of variance that we're doing. So perhaps with the new, you know, knowing the new way of, or another way of doing it, which is quicker, they're remembering that more than the other way, so that we're doing less dose reduction, but we're doing it on the wrong screen more often. But definitely education, and we are doing our in-services now to retrain the doctors to do it appropriately. So hopefully we'll see a change.
Okay. Thank you very much. Thank you.